Hi everyone, welcome to Cat King's everyday video series. Today I'm going to be talking to you guys about MyCAT exam. So I hope all of you guys who are here have heard about MyCAT and about MyCAT College. It's an amazing college for marketing and communications. If you've not heard about it as yet, please make sure you watch the video right till the end. And after that video, I'll tell you guys a couple of things which you must do to get excited about MyCAT as a college and as the campus which it offers, okay? And people who are watching me for the first time, so guys, this is Anisha here, your guide and mentor for all the non-CAT entrance exams at Cat King. I did my MBA from NMIMS, then a short executive management from Harvard Business School. Post that, I actually worked with Marico and Henkel in their strategy and marketing for like 5 countries. And I've been someone who's very passionate about marketing. So MyCAT is one college which is really close to my heart, and I love the program that MyCAT has. So let's do one thing, let's have a quick understanding about the various programs it offers, and you know, what is the selection criteria and how do you go about it further ahead, okay? So first thing first, let's know more about MyCAT. What is it and why is it called the School of Ideas? So firstly, you need to understand that it is the only college which is actually not a B school but an M school. Why do we call it an M school is because it is dedicated to marketing, and you have so much in depth and so much of knowledge and subjects which are strongly based on marketing and communications that it makes it, and it is called also the Mecca of marketing, right? Then you have a really amazing strong alumni network which is based across various corporate companies which you can look at. In fact, I know so many of my students themselves who have been working with Uber, Nykaa, HUL, and getting in best of the companies for their brand marketing roles and digital marketing profiles. So it's an amazing school, I must say to you, for sure to keep an eye on. Then look at what are the kind of programs. So now they have two programs. One is the PGDMC and one is the PGDM program. So there's a conventional program which has been going on for years, and the new PGDM program as well, which is equivalent to the MBA itself, and it is at par with the existing program which existed from decades as well also, okay? And like I said, it's so specialized into marketing that if you look at the specializations which you have an option to choose in your second year, in a regular MBA you will have the option to choose finance, marketing, operations, IT. So you know, you're choosing broad subjects. Here what you're doing is, you know, it's marketing. In marketing you're going to choose your specializations. It could be advertising and brand, digital communications, media and entertainment, marketing analytics, all of these which are like the buzzwords these days, like MarTech is doing wonders, digital marketing is revolutionizing all the organizations. So this is one place you got to make sure you are very, very sure of. If marketing is what you are interested in, this is one of the colleges for you to keep an eye on. With respect to now the placements, if you look at it, the various brands which come on campus, which are like HUL, P&G, L'Oreal, Amazon, Walmart, Google, a lot of companies. In fact, a lot of IT companies also, for example, like IBM, and you know, these startups come in place wherein they look at the design thinking roles or a design manager, and all of these kind of exciting profiles. Okay, so in fact, there are a lot of companies which open profiles like a creative director specifically only for MyCAT and not for other organizations, right? So that's something which you have to look, keep an eye for. In fact, you also have companies which come in from overseas. In the pandemic, the overseas companies were kind of a little taken a back seat, but otherwise you have a lot of good companies coming in, like the NBA comes there for internships, and you have Tolaram Group which comes in, which is, you know, you may feel it's like a very silly group, but or a silly name that comes to your mind, but it's got amazing profiles and amazing packages as well. All right, then we look at the kind of sectors which are covered. You have all sectors, be it from Amazon, like an e-commerce, to FMCG, FMCD, analytics, banking, retail, media. You have agencies is like a big wow thing, like a Dentsu comes on board. Then you have Merkle Sokrati comes on board. You know, you get to see on this side of being the one who's handling various clients as well. The highest package domestic has been 49 lakhs, mean has been 14 lakhs, median has been 13. You will see the mean or the median is a kind of on the lower side, because if you look at the advertising or the media sector, kind of pays lesser in the start. So that's something which you can always grow gradually as you grow in the organization. All right. Then the some of the major USPs which you can look out for is that it offers you pure marketing programs. Brand management, media and entertainment, corporate communications, all of these. There are a lot of interesting subjects, like for example, you know, consumer behavior is what we study. Here you go one notch higher, you will study the understanding about the cultural diversity, how cultural the various cultures affect the marketing choices, the decision making, market research. So a complete insight into, like for example, if tomorrow you want to start your own brand, what should you do, right from thinking about its name to finally making you an iconic brand like an Apple or a Nike, is going to be taught to you guys in the 2 years of your curriculum at Mica. Okay, so this is a lot about the school, the college, why it is called as the Mecca of marketing and the school of ideas. Okay, now let's talk about how do you get into Mica, right? So first thing, you have to make sure you're giving any one of these exams, which is a CAT, ZAT or a GMAT. Okay, now your percentile may vary based on your performance in MyCAT. Ideally, it should be like a 90 percentile in CAT, 85 percentile in ZAT and a 650 in GMAT. There is no sectional cutoffs, so do not worry about the sectional cutoff aspects, but look at an overall maximizing score. So that's a good advantage at your hand. Secondly, you have two attempts of MyCAT. MyCAT is the Mica's own entrance exam, which has different sections. Three major things which you can look into. One is the psychometric, which is like a qualifier, the descriptive section, and an aptitude section. Okay. Now, how the shortlisting goes is, first they will see your qualifier. Did you clear psychometric or not? If you cleared, then your CAT, ZAT or GMAT is evaluated. And then we look into your descriptive section, and then we look into your aptitude section of MyCAT and how that makes into a composite score. Once you have your composite score, then finally you get the Mica call, which is like getting shortlisted for the next stage, which includes group exercise and personal interview. So two aspects towards it. Okay, group exercise is one of the most unique aspects which is there in Mica. It's going to be so different, it's going to be so much fun that you, once you're done with the whole process, you're going to come out smiling and be like, I had fun in this interview. You will have group exercises where you're told to present like a PowerPoint presentation, you're asked to have a mock MUN there, you're asked to do a street play, or you know, enacting it out. So you can do road shows, you can do consulting, you can create jingles, you are given art and craft things to create, posters and all of these things. So it's going to be really fun and exciting. So where your group dynamics are evaluated and your creative thinking also is tested, right? Once that is done, then you go into personal interview. Now here the GE and PI both are mandatory for everybody. Now it's not like, you know, once you clear this level then you go to the next. Everybody has to give the GE and PI. The PI is very comprehensive. It's kind of usually around 30 minutes, where it revolves around to knowing you as a candidate, what makes you different, what makes you unique, and what makes you passionate about Mica. It's one college which is hell-bent on knowing why you are coming here and what made you make this choice. So you have to be truly passionate from within to be a part of Mica. Just go and check the alum network that they have. You will automatically understand why does it look for this kind of alumni base or student base which comes on board, right? Now that you know all about Mica, I hope you guys took notes. If not, please make sure you go back to the video, check it out, and do one more thing. Is like I told you in the beginning, I'll tell you a couple of things to do. Go to Mica's website, take a tour of the campus, check out and follow certain Mica faculties, like Falguni ma'am is there. You will fall in love with her content. She's like an amazing digital creator. You will understand the whole beauty of the campus and what kind of an open studying environment that it offers, right? So that's what I'm talking about. Go check it out, okay? Once you have seen that, then you need to come back here to this video where we will see the paper pattern. I've been doing a separate video where we talk about the structure in detail, the syllabus and how to go about preparing as well. But here is like a quick synopsis of the MyCAT paper pattern. cats at GMAT, they are separate videos, you can check that out. Today I'm talking about just my cat. So the first thing you have is a psychometric test, which is 150 questions, 30 minutes time. Second, you have the descriptive writing, where you have four questions, which essentially are into two categories. One, which is your for and against. Second, which is your creative writing, which is images, and a descriptive writing also it is called. You have 25 minutes for it. Then comes your third section, which is your aptitude section, where we have four sections. This is a pattern as of last year. So we had four sections, 20 questions in each, total 80 questions, 80 minutes time. And there is negative marking in this aptitude section, not the others. Okay, now this aptitude section is also totally different. You have something called as divergent and convergent thinking. Check out my next video to understand more in depth about the same. There is verbal ability, quants and data interpretation. And last, there is general awareness, which is GK, which you need to understand. Okay, so this is a quick understanding of the overall paper. You have to understand it's an online exam which has 2 hours and 15 minutes. Combine all of these things, you will see that it's a 2 hour 15 minute exam. Plus, you have to keep in mind sectional navigation is not allowed. So you cannot keep shifting ki main psychometrics se chalo descriptive chale jaun, descriptive se go to aptitude. You can't shift that way. So you have to make sure, if you have to go one by one in the timed order, in the same flow which is there. You can't toggle between the sections. Okay, now how do you want to get started? If you are really passionate about Mica, you have done the job and the homework of checking out Mica's website, then let's gear up and get started. Something you must have read on Mica's website, which is there, you know, you need to develop your left and the right brain is what makes you Mica ready. All right, so we will take care of doing that for you with your aptitude preparation through your Mica Monday sessions and everyday life classes for your CAT, ZAT, as well as MyCAT preparation. There are additional specific ebooks for Mica and practice questions. You will have more focus on your building your creativity by understanding, you know, the story writing and analytical writing approach from Mikins, through video lectures, through sample writing, so that you can relate and understand to the same. There will be practice for you guys through full mocks, sectional tests, creative writing tests, and workshops, specifically where I will be taking those workshops to help you build that creative bent of mind. How do you start writing and be something you are so good at that people fall in love with your stories? And last but not the least will be your group exercise and personal interview, where we will have a special series of webinars where we'll bring in a lot of Micans, seniors, alums to get you on board to understand what and how you should be studying to make sure you are able to crack the GEPI. All right, so these are all the things which are going to make sure helps you to get ready for Mica, get on board with the same thing. And if you're really passionate about it, then check out the description in the details and get on board with the Mica Super 30 batch. Me, along with a lot of Mica alums and students, will be guiding you guys and preparing you guys through the entire journey from the exam till you walk into the Mica School of Ideas. Okay, so thank you so much guys, all the best. I hope the video was helpful for all of you guys, and in case if you guys like the videos and would want me to cover up more aspects about Mica and the MyCAT exam, drop in your comment section and make sure you do not miss subscribing to the channel. All right, all the best, bye bye, take care.